Hi friends, this is Paramesh Malgon, HR professional, mentor and tutor. Now I am going to teach English grammar in English language. So today's class is 7, and in this class I am going to teach past tense. In past tense, totally 4 sub tenses are there, like simple past tense, past continuous tense, past perfect tense, past perfect continuous tense. Okay. So many people are asking some questions like how I should watch the English grammar teaching, because I want to learn English grammar in English. Some people are asking, I want to learn English grammar in Hindi. Some people are asking, I would like to learn English grammar in Kannada. Okay, so after uploading my teaching videos at YouTube, I am updating information at LinkedIn and Facebook. Please you can watch my teaching at YouTube channel only, because you will be getting clear quality pictures and audios, also quality video and audio. And in YouTube, what happens, my channel name is Paramesh Malgon, PARMESH MALGOND. So Paramesh Malgon is a channel name. Okay, so just you search and you'll be getting my channel. You can subscribe if you are not subscribed. So already those who are subscribed, that is good always. In that, what I made separate playlist, separate folder. So English grammar in English, that is separate folder. In that, many class 1, class 2 videos are uploaded. English grammar in Hindi also I uploaded separate folder. English grammar in Kannada also separate folder is there. In particular folder, all classes are there, class 1, class 2. Don't get confused. In each language, I made class 1, class 2, okay, like that. Infinity classes are there, okay. I am continuously teaching. And those who are watching first time this video, please watch from the beginning, from the class 1. Choose any one language, either English or Hindi or Kannada. Whichever language you are very much comfortable, you can choose that language. In that, you can learn English grammar. So then you can continuously practice it, okay. So please watch this video until ending. So after watching, if you like this, like it, share it and subscribe it. Please refer many people, many friends, though your neighbors, colleagues, okay, friends, classmates, let them also learn, and then let them also get benefit from my teaching. So let's go for learning English grammar in English, friends. Now we are going to learn past tense. In past tense, simple past tense, okay. Past tense means already we did work previously, okay. 1 minute back, 2 minutes back, half an hour, 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, 1 year back, like that. Whatever previously we have done work, for that we can call past tense, okay. Let us learn which are the pronouns, which are the helping verbs we should use, and what will be the main verb, and what will be the how to create the sentence. Let us learn, okay. Now I'll tell you. Suppose in positive sentence, in a simple present tense, if any pronouns comes, okay, on that moment we should not use any helping verb, okay. Suppose if it is positive, we should not use any helping verb. And if it is negative, we should use the helping verb, should be did, okay. And the main verb should be, in positive sentence, the main verb should be past tense. And in negative sentence, the main verb should be present tense, okay. Let's go learn one by one. I tell you, now I am going to write first positive sentence, means I am going to create, okay. In sentence, what are the things should be there? Subject, helping verb is not coming here, okay, it doesn't come. Main verb and object. Main verb should be past tense, means main verb, the kinds of verbs, verb 1, verb 2 and verb 3. Here verb 2 should be there. Verb 2 means verb 1 is past tense, so present tense, verb 2 past tense, verb 3 past participle. Here kinds of verbs, no, the verb 2 should be there, means past tense, okay. So here any pronoun should be there. For any pronouns, we should apply the main verb, should be past tense only. And
here helping of doesn't come. Okay, object will be same a song. If you are singing many songs, you can mention many songs. Okay, one more example is here, I drank milk. Okay, let's read one by one example. I sang a song, we sang a song, you sang a song, he sang a song, she sang a song, it sang a song, they sang a song. Okay, now let's go for learning negative sentence. In negative sentence, subject and helping verb comes here. Okay, and with that negative word also comes, and the main verb should be in present tense. Whenever the helping verb come in negative and in a simple past tense, okay, while creating a negative sentence, at that moment the main verb becomes present tense. Okay, this is past object. Okay, for any pronoun, I, we, you, he, she, it, they, any pronoun, the helping verb will come only did, not only did. Okay, this is negative word, this is did is a helping verb. I did not sing a song, we did not sing a song, you did not sing a song, he did not sing a song, she did not sing a song, it did not sing a song, they did not sing a song. Okay, now let's go for learning interrogative sentence. In interrogative sentence, first WH word should be there. For any pronoun, WH word will come first, and helping verb will be did comes, and here the subject will be there. Okay, here the main verb, whenever the negative sentence or interrogative sentence, if you are creating in simple past tense, on that moment the main verb will be in present tense. Okay, and here object will be either a song or many songs. If you are mentioning many, then it should be songs. If you are singing one song, you mention a song. Okay, so for any pronouns helping verb comes did only. Okay, let's go for reading one by one example. I did not write here, I did not use I and we example. Okay, because we should not create ourselves, we should not ask questions ourselves. That's what I did not write. If you want, you can write, you can practice. Okay, why did you sing a song? You should ask questions in such a way, if you are reading, the opposite person should know that I am asking a question. Okay, you should not read like this, why did you sing a song, like that. Why did you sing a song? Why did he sing a song? Why did she sing a song? Why did it sing a song? Why did they sing a song? The opposite person should feel like that this is a question. Okay, some people read like this. Okay, they will understand only meaning of word. Okay, why did you sing a song? They will not open mouth also. Okay, but they will read slowly in their mouth and mind. They will not understand that sentence only. Okay, should read very fast like this. Why did you sing a song? Why did he sing a song? Why did she sing a song? Why did it sing a song? Why did they sing a song? Let's go for learning yes or no questions now. Okay, so in yes or no sentence, the person if asking questions, you should answer yes or no word only. That's it. Yes, you should tell yes or no. Don't reply with big sentence. Okay, so in yes or no sentence, first here helping verb comes. Okay, after that subject, in that this pronouns, the stage which are the, these pronouns are located at subject place. Okay, here the main verb will become present tense. Okay, and this is object. Okay, for any pronoun helping verb comes only did. Okay, and main verb will be sing in the present tense. Did you sing a song? Did he sing a song? Did she sing a song? Did it sing a song? Did they sing a song? Okay, now I will read very fast. Let us see. Did you sing a song? Did he sing a song? Did she sing a song? Did it sing a song? Did they sing a song?
Friends, I taught you simple past tense. So please, you can go through one by one example details. So for which pronoun, what are the helping verbs we need to use, and how to use main verbs. In positive sentence, the helping verb doesn't come. But while creating negative sentence, interrogative sentence and yes or no sentence, helping verb comes, we need to use. And in positive sentence, the main verb will become past tense. But in negative sentence, interrogative sentence and yes or no sentence, main verb becomes present tense. Okay, so if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe, and please watch my YouTube channel Paramesh Malgonde at YouTube only, because I am updating for spreading the news at LinkedIn and WhatsApp. So please, you can share as many friends, because let them learn, let them get benefit from this teaching. So I will see you in the next video and next class. Until then, take care, goodbye.